How can you tell if you've got Bonnie and Clyde syndrome?
Is it those people who've got, like, one half they're dressed as a man and the other half they're dressed as a woman? And they sort of go do variety shows in probably somewhere like Albania these days. It's probably the only place to have them.
It's not...
Is that woman on the left got it?
No, I don't think so. Peculiarly enough, Bonnie might have had it, but Clyde certainly didn't. It's a paraphilia. Do you know what a paraphilia is?
It's an erotic attachment to something wrong. Or
yeah, it's like a fetish or a taboo or something like that. It can be for a physical... not necessarily bank robbery. It's one of the few paraphilias that more women have than men, this particular one. It's called hubristophilia. Women who fall for very dangerous, violent criminals.
Mm. Right.
In Britain alone, there are estimated to be at least 100 women who are engaged... to Americans on death row.
People who have correspondence.
Just that's British women who've never even been there, who are engaged to, yeah. Not just corresponding, but engaged to.
Not to mention the wives of Tory MPs.
Yeah, well, right. It's an erotic, sort of fetishistic, strange love that people have for violent criminals. I mean, real wrong-uns, not just like, oh, he's a naughty boy, but, I mean, murderers of the worst possible kind.
She appears to be going, lose weight!
That's the real Bonnie and Clyde.
Yeah, the casting was quite favourable to them.
It was, wasn't it?
I've never seen a picture of them.
Yeah. He just used to wear a hat.
There are no Faye Dunaway and Warren Beatty in real life, has to be said.
Yeah. No, the real Clyde Barrett was an absolute institutional criminal. I mean, a really violent, unpleasant man who murdered a lot and killed many people. But Bonnie might have had this. A lot of the gang members said she never raised a gun or killed anybody, and that she was fond of poetry, she was privately educated, she was intelligent, and maybe she actually had hubristophilia for Clyde.
So why would men not find that as appealing?
I don't know, maybe it's something to do with the risk of being sort of clichéic about these things, that some of women's belief that they can improve people in the way that men don't seem to have that desire to believe...
Imagine seriously violent criminals are quite good at sex.
Are they?
I don't know, I'm just guessing it.
Say they are, or
Thank you for watching. Do remember to subscribe to the QI channel and click here to watch more videos.